This is the Sonos application for the Sonos Arc. What we're looking at here is right here on our bottom, we have several different selections for the Sonos app. Right now we're on the first one right here, which is the star, which is the My Sonos page. This My Sonos page will show you recently played and then where you pulled it from. So this is a Pandora station, this is an Amazon station, here's another Pandora station. You also have the ability to see Sonos Radio or discover Sonos Radio. So if we were to kind of come through here and look very quickly and select 80s flash, here you can see it's actually loading it on, and then down here it's got the now playing area. So my Sonos bar downstairs is now freaking my cats out and playing music when I'm not around. You can pause or start again your music. We're just gonna pause that for now, and then we're gonna come down because that was our Sonos Radio Discover Sonos Radio, and then trending now on Sonos Radio. Sonos does have their own premium radio station that you can pay for. Most of this is actually pulling from their free services. Over here you have your edit button. So if there's something that you want to remove, you can do so by either clicking the little button next to it. If you have something in your recently played that you don't want there anymore, simply click it and it will go away, and then select done. And then you're brought back to your My Sonos area. Over here you have notifications. So here it's just kind of letting you know something that it wants you to pay attention to. For me, it's around the holiday season. It's trying to get me to buy more stuff. Moving along, we've got our browse selection. So right here, you could see Sonos Radio. Selecting that will bring you into Sonos Radio, which looks a lot like the Sonos area that we were at before. If you attach your Amazon Music, iHeartRadio, Pandora, Plex, Pocket Cast, there's a plethora of things that you can actually attach to this area. My one complaint about this area is actually the Plex, which I thought would actually pull from my Plex Media server, and it does not. It actually just kind of pulls from podcast related stuff. So not the best in my opinion. You also have the ability to pull from TV on this device and add services if you want. Selecting add services will pull up all the services that you can add from. And I will admit there is a lot of services. So any of these you can set up, and hypothetically, if I were to come to iHeartRadio and select this particular radio station, right now it is playing live on my Sonos downstairs. We'll let that go for a little bit because we're gonna pop over to this, which is system. Right now it is showing living room, which is my Sonos Arc. It's the only Sonos soundbar I have. Right now you can see it's actually playing what's on here. But if I were to stop this, you'll see that kind of trickles down. I can come up here and then select living room or deselect it. If you had other Sonos items, they would show up here. Select done. If you had something playing on your TV set, you could set it for night mode or enhanced vocals, which will allow you to up the sound of people talking over explosions and everything, or the night mode, which will compress the actual audio sound that you're getting. Moving along to the bottom here, we have search. So you could search for artist, song, album, playlist, genre. They will search for just about anything. So if we do a quick search, and I will do quick search for Weird Al. So it's pulling from specific Sonos stations or Pandora, because those are the things that I have loaded on here. And here you see it pulls them all into this stations area after I did the search. And we've got some iHeartRadio playlists. So this area is gonna be for your searching. Last but not least, for your Sonos app is over here, which is actually the settings area. Selecting the settings area will have at the top the account that's associated with it. So that's kind of out of the way right now. We've got our system, which will allow us to add a new product. We went through this during the setup process. You can select add product and then your particular Sonos speaker. About my system, here it will tell you all the information that we need to know about my particular Sonos Arc. You've got AirPlay, you've got alarm settings. So if you want to set an alarm for your particular Sonos speaker, you could. Audio compression, likewise, you can select how you want your speaker to handle sound. Since I have it wired and at home, I have it uncompressed. I want to get all the sound that I can from it. And then date and time, you can have selections there. I do not have a group because, well, my only speaker at the moment. Media server, that's gonna give you some specifics for setting up servers. If you don't know that, just stay out of there. Music library, again, this is going to pull in a bunch of information from all of your libraries. So if you have something you want it indexed, it'll set it up regularly to index. Network, well, just like it sounds, that's network information, whether you have it, have your particular speaker connected wirelessly or wired. Parental controls, yes, there are parental controls, so you can filter for explicit song lyrics. So if you have a station that has both versions, it will pull the non-explicit one, and then services that filter content currently that I have associated with this is Amazon Music. Coming back, we have the option for system update. Mine automatically checks, but you can check for an update manually, or you can set a scheduled update, or by default it is overnight, so it doesn't interfere with you actually using it. And then last is transfer ownership of system if you wanted to give your soundbar to somebody else. Now that was all under system. So we have services and voice assistants. So right now I have my Alexa connected to this. Not only can you do voice assistants, you have your connected music services right there. We're gonna go back. App preferences, well, this is gonna give you basically what the app looks like and does. So system default, dark mode, or light mode. You can show notifications, show app shortcut, show on lock screen, which I have turned off, enable search history, confirm location. You can turn that off if you don't want it to necessarily know where you are, allow pop-up messages, home screen controls. I have those disabled. Find my apps. So that will search your device and show you, hey, these are things that you already have on here. Let me bring them in. You have your support information right here. So if you need any help with your Sonos Arc or the application itself, you can pop right in there. Data and privacy, just like it sounds. Same with legal. All that is kind of self-explanatory. And then you have your inbox and right here, those messages that I was talking about before. Timing is everything. These are kind of ways to get you to purchase things through the Sonos app itself. So here, like I said, I'm filming this around the holiday shopping season. And then we will come back to the front. And that was a quick look at the Sonos app for the Sonos Arc soundbar.